Thank you very much, Siobhan. Let's start with Limerick. Limerick goalkeeper Nicky Quaid has kept two clean sheets in the last two games, the Munster final and an All-Ireland semi-final. So credit to him and his six-man defence. The full-back position might be new to Dan Morrissey, but he hasn't put a foot wrong. But he's two fine hurlers to his left and right in Sean Finn and Barry Nash. Team captain is number six, Declan Hannan. Darragh O'Donovan and William O'Donoghue are John Kiley's first choice in centre field. That decision means Cian Lynch can move forward to lead the attack, whereas two wingmen, Gerard Hegarty and Tom Morrissey, have been in scintillating form. Good news for Limerick is that Aaron Gillan has recovered from his injury in the semi-final, so he will start at top of the right. Stephen O'Keefe has been first choice keeper for Waterford for about 8 years now. His 6'5" full-back Conor Prunty from Abbeyside leads the team, with Ian Kenny and Shane McNulty in the corners. Tadhg De Burka has been simply awesome at centre-back, with Caelum Lyons and Kevin Moore outstanding on the wings. Jamie Barron has an incredible engine, which complements his great stick work, while his centre-field partner is Ballysackard's Kieran Bennett. Neil Montgomery starts for the first time at 11, after some massive contributions as a substitute, but he has the outstanding Stephen Bennett to his left. For Waterford to bridge that 61-year gap, much will depend on how Desi Hutchinson and Austin Gleeson perform in the inside line. On the substitutes bench, both managers John Kiley and Liam Cahill have options. Aaron Costello, Richie English, Paddy O'Loughlin are top-class defenders, while Adrian Breen, Peter Casey, David Reedy and Pat Ryan are proven forwards with an eye and a touch for scores. The Desha have the fast-moving Peter Hogan ready and available at number 17, while Mikey Carney, Patrick Curran and Colin Dunford are serious contenders for being introduced if the attack needs to be redesigned. Conor Gleeson, Darragh Lyons, Jake Dillon are quality players who can play absolutely anywhere. Well, it's good to see Shane Fives returning after picking up an injury in the Munster final.
Well, it is pretty still here and that sun has gone down, so I'm not too sure how important the toss is in relation to who wins and who shoots which way. But we are very aware that there are mammies and daddies and sisters and brothers and partners and friends and men and women who have had influences on these men since before they could even hold a hurley or a slitter in their hands, who are sitting at home watching this instead of filling those stands here in Croke Park. We are going to do our very, very best to try to bring you as close to the match as is humanly possible. We know it's not the same thing, but do bear in mind that we are thinking of you and we do know that you should be here watching these men in action today. Anthony, let's get to the thing everybody wants to know. Who's picking up who? What are the key matchups today?
Oh, God, Joanne, trying to predict matchups is a bit of a nightmare, to be honest, because somebody moves somewhere else rapidly. But look, I think the key ones, I think Waterford got an awful lot right in the Munster final in some ways. I think the two wing forwards obviously are contenders for Hurler of the Year in Hegarty and Morrissey. And yet, on the day, Tom Morrissey was whipped off fairly early on Kevin Moran. And Callum Lyons did a very good job on Gerard Hegarty, maybe up to the last quarter.
And Hegarty, of course, may have had an injury carried into that game.
He may have, is right, coming into it. But I don't really think it's John Kiley's form to play an injured player. But he did a good job for a long period. Now, Hago did get on top a bit near the end. Fagan and Kyle Hayes, looks an intriguing one in the air. I just wonder, would there be a fly in the ointment somewhere there, like a Stephen Bennett going centre forward on Declan Hannan, and maybe he's been operating on the wing all year and very successfully, but would they maybe go for Declan Hannan there?
But Hannan wouldn't pick him up,
well,
though, would
he? Well, that's the thing, but it might just force them to funnel Will O'Donoghue back or Darragh O'Donovan back. The other thing as well, Jan, always in these All-Irelands we say, who's the fly in the ointment? Is it a Jack Prendergast or someone to come out of nowhere? Darragh O'Donovan maybe to shoot 4 or 5 points. Something like that often comes up in All-Ireland final day.
I think one of the key ones for me is Cian Lynch because Tadhg De Burka. Tadhg De Burka is just so critical to Waterford. He'll sit back in that pocket. But as well, I found him this year, he's pushing on a lot more. Cian Lynch brings you a lot more problems. So what Waterford do with him will be a big, big outcome in the game.
Surely Kieran Bennett, though, I'd say, be picked midfield. Henry's just with a view to picking him at a certain stage.
But Anthony, again, you're sucking yourself back. Are you going to win playing that way? I think Waterford, the thing for me is that since the Munster final, I thought they were going out to contain Limerick. I think if you're going to beat him, you may go at him and just push Tadhg De Burka up and try and do it. I know it's easy for us to do it up here.
Big thing for me, Joanne, in any of the matchups that Anthony or Henry have been talking about there, it's hard really to be sure where Waterford would have the advantage in any of those matchups. I think it's actually the opposite, and I think that's a big problem for Waterford today, because they are going to be depending on their system. From a Limerick point of view, though, I think that it's a challenge from a psychological point of view to make sure that they're on the top of their game and that they're not overconfident to win in this one.
Let's get the quickest of predictions from each of you. Who's going to be the 2020 All-Ireland Hurling Champions? Anthony?
I think Limerick to win it back, join after a great battle.
Donal Logue?
Said 10 January Limerick. I'm not going to...
And Henry?
Yeah, three in a row, Limerick again.
Three in a row for Limerick on the panel. Can it be two in 3 years for the Limerick Hurlers? We'll find out very shortly. August Nolte in Niki Jarmid, Gwil Trochtrock, Le Fall, Aaron Glea in Yalega, Le Pat Flurry, August Gary McDonagh, Shin Air on RT News Channel, August Air on RT Player. But for us here, for the Senior All Ireland Hurling Final of 2020, our commentary team at Croke Park are Michael and Marty.
Thank you so much, Joanne. It really is an All-Ireland hurling final like no other. The quietness outside the grounds is deafening on Jones's and Conliffe Road. There's nobody selling hats or flags. There's nobody looking for tickets. No horns hooting, no banners saying that they love their county. It's eerily silent. Normally there are 82,300 people here, but today Croke Park is empty, apart from the Limerick and Waterford teams and their officials. It's the effect of COVID-19 on our country. But let's be positive. We have made it this far. There are 12 days to Christmas. Can you believe it? And here we are with one of Ireland's greatest showpieces, the All-Ireland Hurling Final. Your ticket today may not be in the Upper Hogan, Lower Cusick or Hill 16, because all tickets are the same this afternoon, watching the TV or listening on the radio. So wherever you are right now, in your jersey, in your kitchen in Patrick's Well, your sitting room in Ballysagard, you might be all dolled up with nowhere to go in your apartment in New York or Dubai. You might even be in your pyjamas in bed in Sydney. Welcome to Croke Park. We're all in a world pandemic right now trying to mind each other, but we're here together, united by a great love of hurling. And let's enjoy this for a little while and forget our worries as two great teams, Limerick and Waterford, battle it out for the ultimate honour of being crowned All-Ireland Champions 2020. Michael Dagnan and myself feel deeply privileged to be your commentary team today. It is a very different and unique All-Ireland final day. Formation flypass is provided by the number three operations wing from the Irish Air Corps. The formation will be led by a Leonardo AW139 helicopter with the Irish tricolour on display suspended from the cargo hook. An Airbus H135 helicopter will complete the formation. It is All-Ireland Hurling Final Day. It is December 13th, 2020. Michael Dagnan.
It is, Marty, and look, it's strange as you say, but it's unbelievable to me that we're here. 2 months ago, 3 months ago, people said there'd be no championship. Would it be a COVID? Would it be affected, whoever won it? You ask a person from Limerick or from Waterford that's at home now listening to us. This will be as important as any All-Ireland that was ever won. If Waterford can win it for the first time since 59, or can Limerick win their third in the last 50 years?
Fergal Horgan is the All-Ireland referee. It's his second All-Ireland. He also was in charge in 2017. Who's it going to be? Limerick going for their ninth. Waterford for their third and their first since 1959. Limerick won the toss, they've decided to play from left to right, and away they go with Seamus Flanagan getting on the ball as quickly as possible, being challenged by Ty de Burka. Flanagan lays it back. Waterford back there in plenty numbers, good defending as Waterford, the ball slither bobbling all over the place initially. You can see there's a bit of a scrum here, and still trying to dig it out is Ty de Burka. Grabbing it, however, is Ian Kenny. Loses possession. Limerick have it now. Ball come back out. That's great pressure by Waterford. Ball bobbles all over the place. In there is Ian Kenny again. Trying to pick it up is Tom Morrissey. Tom gets a little bit of space. Has his first shot at goal, and the white flag is raised. Limerick are up and running after 43 seconds of play.
Yeah, Martin, a hard passage to play there at the very start of the game. You saw the rooks, the tackling, the hooking. Tom Morrissey, though, what a game he had the last day against Galway. He had five from play, and there he is popping up with the first one.
Beautifully caught by Tom Morrissey's brother Dan, who has adapted to life from wing-back to full-back so well this winter. Waterford going into their first attack. There's an opportunity. Here, a shot! And across the face of the goal off the stick of Jack Fagan. It must have. Watch this. Nicky Quaid was covering his near post.
Oh, what a chance that was, Marty. He went for the rocket to the top corner and just flashed outside the post. It was a brilliant chance.
Good effort by Fagan. Now playing, of course, with De La Salle Club in Waterford. Gone across to take this is Jamie Barron from 4 Mile Water. Now a school teacher in Coolnessmere in West Waterford. He's been outstanding in this championship. Cuts it in, just tails to the left and wide.
Yeah, and that's something. Here we go again. The goal chance should have been stuck in the net, and that line ball going wide. We saw Joe Kenny in the last day scoring four, but better off to keep them balls in play.
Long delivery from Dermot Burns, gathered by Seamus Flanagan, or attempting to gather it. Difficult angle. His back was to the goalpost. Oh, that is a superb point. Seamus Flanagan. Great score.
Yeah, and look, a lot of people saying he's in the team for his strength only. That's not the case. He's a fantastic hurler as well. That's two balls that come his way. He's won both of them. You see that there now. That's the confidence that it gives him in the first minute of the game.
Puck out from Stephen O'Keefe. Gathered by Kieran Bennett, but he loses the possession. Here comes Tom Morrissey. Here's the call. Julie delivers. Slither dropped momentarily by Sean Finn. Lays it off. There's a chance of a shot at goalpost, but that is the wrong side of the post. Stephen O'Keefe, the puck out strategy is going to be interesting. At the moment it's going long. Here comes Kieran Bennett. Well blocked. Darrow Donovan. Still Kieran Bennett battling hard along the sideline. Jeremy Burns is in there. Scooping it up with Jack Prendergast. Schlitter in the right-hand paw. Great tenacity by Limerick. Here comes Gerard Hegarty. Looking for it is Keane Lynch right beside him. Gerard Hegarty, scorer of 13 points on this journey to the All-Ireland final. Give me a... Tom Morrissey, Conor Prunty. Here comes Seamus Flanagan. Trying to dig it out is Aaron Gillan. Ty De Burka comes away with it. Such an important figure, flicks it forward. Referee had spotted the infringement by Limerick. Free to Waterford.
Yeah, you see there now what Limerick do so well. The man off the shoulder there, Garrett Hegarty, Keane Lynch, winning those ruck balls, but Ty De Burka gets back in that one. He's been having a great year, burst out, was fouled, a good advantage by the ref, but played it back then. And Stephen Bennett come back an awful long way to take this, but he is a phenomenal free taker.
What an amazing championship this young man has had. A goal and 44 points, 33 frees. He's on his own 45, he's hit it powerfully. Oh, brilliant, absolutely brilliant free taking by Stephen Bennett. And it's so important for free takers to put the first one over because it gives them a confidence.
It does, Marty. There's Keane Lynch now on his own from the puck out.
He shouldn't leave Keane Lynch unmarked. That's rather untypical of him.
Well, that's Ty De Burka. He's trying to drop back in front of the full back line and cover him as well. And Lynch is drifting. Hegarty's in at centre forward at the minute. But Nicky Quaid's puck out's crucial in every game for Limerick. He's one of the best in the business.
Batted down for Keane Lynch to gather. He gives it to William O'Donoghue. Back far is the Limerick captain, Declan Hannan. Down towards Aaron Gillan. De Burka goes back to sweep it up. Stephen O'Keefe has moved just outside his goal area. Goes long, down far is Jack Prendergast. Good diagonal ball. Arriving superbly is Desi Hutchinson. Neil Montgomery was gone inside, but Hutchinson was taken down by the Limerick captain from Adair, Declan Hannan. Well won by Hutchinson, it must be said, but pulled down here.
He was, Marty, but he should have given the hand pass inside. You mentioned it there, Neil Montgomery, gone off his shoulder, slipping the hand pass. He was straight through on goal to have the consolation of a tap over free.
Surprisingly, Michael, no card for Declan Hannan either, as it looked to deliberate.
Well, it was very cynical and it should have been a yellow card.
Stephen Bennett taps that over the bar. Nicky Quaid heads down towards the Hogan stand side this time. Batted down by Tom Morrissey for Garrodhig. Oh, that's a sweet little dink of a ball. In first, the man himself, Keane Lynch, bearing down on goal. And Waterford were really exposed there, but they recovered well, to their credit. That had the potential of rattling the back of the Waterford net. Sean Finn to Declan Hanna. Good play. Kyle Hayes. You've now seen the complete Limerick half back line. The diagonal ball is hit too strongly. This time, sideline ball for Waterford. But just a little bit of nervousness the way Limerick are. Early days, nothing major, but still signs.
Yeah, a couple of chances there. A bad wide there by Hegarty and Keane Lynch, but great defending here by Tadhg Na Burka. You see the left arm maybe in there fouling, but he got back on him and the ref didn't deem it a free.
Shane McNulty with the sideline cut that went to a bit short. Rebounds into the pathway of right corner back Ian Kenny. First touch was not bad at all, considering the pace of the ball that it was hit at. But Jack Prendergast unable to control it. Sideline cut for Limerick. Just to give you the weather here in Dublin, it's a beautiful, beautiful afternoon, considering we are in December. And a little puff of breeze, just possibly favouring. It's more of a crossbow breeze. Down on the pitch, the flags are quite still and limp. So it's ideal conditions for an All-Ireland hurling final. Once again, it's Tadhg Na Burka. This time under pressure from Graham Mulcahy, concedes a sideline ball. Garrod Hegarty wanted to take it quickly. In towards Tom Morrissey, trying to make a bit of space. Jamie Barron was coming in to challenge, and Tom Morrissey squeezes that inside the left-hand post. Brilliant score.
Well, I was going to say he should have passed it out to Kyle Hayes outside him. He was off his left shoulder, but that's a brilliant score. He just eased back and tucked it up in the air and let it carry over the bar.
Sean Finn under a little bit of pressure here. Pushed out over the sideline. Linesman indicates that's a sideline ball. And that's not an easy thing to do because Garrod Hegarty is all 6'5".
We've seen a lot of Hegarty, Tom Morrissey has scored two, and Keane Lynch. The three of them move and interchange and on the ball a lot since the start of the game.
Liam Cahill watching from the sideline. Former Tipperary star, all-star, back in 96. So that's a good ball. Is there a little touch? Nope. As Nicky Quaid deals with it. Gives it out to Declan Hannan. Kyle Hayes. Adopting from forward life, centre-forward life to wing-back. Aaron Gillan making an angle for himself. He's the confidence to have a goal from an acute angle, and the shooting by Limerick is quite simply superb.
Well, that is some score. First of all, Kyle Hayes bursting out and playing an 80-yard ball. That's what they do, to switch it and change their play so much. Sometimes it's short through the hand, that time a long ball, and Gillan won it from an impossible angle again, Marty. It's a fantastic score.
Two goals and 34 points he scored on the way. Most of that was 27 were actually frees, but he's such a prolific scorer from play as well. Fabulous catch by Dermot Burns. He knows it and we know it. Well done, Dermot.
Yeah, and this is where Waterford went down badly in the Munster final, pucking long puckouts down on top of Dermot Burns and Kyle Hayes. They lost every one of them, and that's like Burns is having a phenomenal year. I think he's 6 from play, 10 points in total so far in the championship. And he'll fancy chances with this one. Keane Lynch playing out on the middle of the field, Marty, being picked up by either Jamie Barron or Kieran Bennett. And Tadhg Na Burka is sitting back as an out-and-out sweeper. I thought he'd push up more on him, but he's not. He's sitting back.
Dermot Burns, all of Limerick scores from play so far. Tadhg Na Burka was in there, but so too was Conor Prunty. Coolness personified, lays it off. And away come Waterford here. Limerick putting the pressure on that half back line, not allowing them to settle. Ball is aimed at Gillan. His first touch, by his standards, wasn't the best, but then he was subsequently fouled.
That score started with the poor clearance by Callum Lyons. He was put under pressure straight away by Garrod Hegarty and Tom Morris. He pucked it up the wing and the ball played back in long. They're such good hurlers in the Limerick half back line that they can get the ball over the sweeper with their striking. It's so good, and Gillan came out there just a little flick and a flick across, and a handy free for him now.
picked up an injury during the semi-final. There was a little bit of concern in the immediate aftermath of that match that Aaron would be fine, but thankfully he's fully recovered. He's been attending training for the last 2 weeks, and he hasn't lost his touch and his free-taking ability either.
Jack Fagan, Neil Montgomery, Stephen Bennett, Austin Gleeson, we haven't seen them on the ball. The half-back line of Limerick dominating so far, and their half-forward, and the two key lines for them being allowed to dominate, and Waterford are going to have to get a grip there.
Stephen O'Keefe going long again, but they're not getting much change out of it, Michael. There were options available there to use the short puck out. Here's Keane Lynch, lovely little wrist work. Ah, oh, beautiful. Limerick, Keane Lynch, Waterford are clearly exposed here. There's an opportunity for goal. Kyle Hayes, brilliant save by Stephen O'Keefe. Not once, but twice. Fantastic, Stephen O'Keefe. But it's not over yet. Here he is. Goalkeeper, superb. Now, that's why he won an All-Star in 2017. This is just fantastic goalkeeping.
Marty, could have been, I'd say, the greatest goal ever scored in Croke Park, except we're after seeing one of the greatest saves. Look at the flick here by Lynch, the 1-2 here with Mulcahy. Look at Kyle Hayes galloping up the field from wing back. He'll never get an easier chance. What a save. That's an unbelievable save. And that one again, even better maybe. And a slap in there from Callum Lyons. What a passage of play.
My word. We've seen some wonderful goalkeepers.
The second save, Marty, I'm just looking at it again. It's just unbelievable, out of this world.
Aaron Gallan will be happy to tap this over the bar for his third point.
Anyone worrying about Limerick's attitude or whether to be overconfident? They're absolutely buzzing. Look at this again. It's just incredible.
Outstanding. Not once, but twice. Can that inspire Waterford? We ask. As the Deja go into the attack, here's a chance for Neil Montgomery. He's getting a chance now. Nicky Quaid is in there, his backliner there. All green jerseys. Here comes Sean Finn from Brough. Makes a little bit of space for himself. Delivers it down towards Seamus Flanagan, who's now playing in his own half back line, trying to pick up that ball. But Waterford surely beginning to feel that with Stephen O'Keefe outstanding, that they could be inspired to step up a gear or two, and they need to. Here comes Ian Kenny from Ballygunner, the right corner back. It's tailing to the left and wide. It's the third wide of the match for Waterford.
And that's Limerick's work rate again, Marty. They forced the ball into the cornerback's hands. No other shooter was getting it. They're closing down. Four Limerick men chasing every single ball. They're making it almost impossible for Waterford.
Long puck out again from Nicky Quaid. Good old Hegarty gets his hands to it. Short ball for Austin Gleeson, who's come out around midfield. He's available for the hand pass again. Here it comes. Gleeson, middle of the field, just along the sideline. That is fantastic. Austin Gleeson, hello. He has arrived in Croke Park.
Well, it might have taken him 14 minutes and a few seconds to get his first touch, but what a score. Tighe the work, I just seen him on the move in full flow. That's what he can do and make it look easy.
Batted down by Tom Morrissey to Gerard Hegarty. The Limerick half forward line looked very powerful. All three have now touched the ball just in that little sequence. Keane Lynch giving it back for his William O'Donoghue. O'Donoghue's shooting is impeccable, and that is between the posts. He scored twice already in this championship against Tipperary. He's got one in the All-Ireland final.
Yeah, decision-making again by Hegarty and Lynch, doing the right thing. And Will O'Donoghue has had a great year for Limerick in the middle of the field, and lovely score.
Waterford goal for the short puck out this time. Stephen O'Keefe to Shane McNulty. Well won by Dan the Man, not from Waterford, but Dan the Man from Ahan in Limerick. Two against two up here, batted down cleverly. Picked up by Caleb Lyons, giving it to Tadhg Na Bhfearca, letting it run along the surface. The hurley is held by Sean Finn. The referee, Fergal Horgan, has his arm outstretched, saying that that was a foul, no advantage developing. It's a free for Waterford.
Yeah, little flick there by Sean Finn. You see him just pulling the hard grep ball in there, and Waterford just do with this. It's been all about Limerick, but Waterford will be glad now just to get a little breather here. Tap this over the bar, and they're going to be back to 3 points.
Stephen Bennett, and a simple tap over point for him. That's three for Waterford from the left half forward from Billy Sackett. Barry Nash. Declan Hannan dispossessed. Just a little bit of indecisiveness. Austin Gleeson seems to pick up an injury there. And Limerick continue on. Declan Hannan has a goal from way out the field. The body language says it all. And the captain scored in this All-Ireland final, as he did against Clare way back in the end of October.
Yeah, and we see that so often with Declan Hannan, just cruising up on the outside of Keane Lynch there. Here's Austin Gleeson here. There's the hurl going in there from Tom Morrissey. And that is sore, and I hope not too serious, because...
Well, he just needs a little bit of time, hopefully, to recover, but certainly a painful one for Austin.
You just see Tom Morrissey going in. In fairness, playing the ball, but...
Yeah.
But a nasty jab at the same time. I ended up in hospital many years ago after an event like that, and it wasn't pleasant.
No, I know. It was an accident in terms of Tom Morris, who was just going for the ball, but it's still painful for Austin. Interesting to want to Limerick's out of their tally. Limerick have scored 6 from play. Just 2 frees. There's Donny, a great cameraman in a former career with us.
Was
good
indeed.
To see him.
Yeah, Austin Gleeson, the only point from play. There's 5 different scores from play for Limerick so far, so you know, you just see how many of them are in on the game. I think, you know, Waterford only scored 12 from play in the Munster final. It was a big factor in that game. They scored 221 the last day against Kilkenny and 216 the second half, so we're going to need more of that flair now between now and half time.
Short puck out. Works all right for Ian Kenny, but certainly puts Craig DeBrock under pressure. Great. Pressure indeed by Limerick as Gerard Hegarty gets the pass. Bursting forward is William O'Donoghue. And Waterford happy to concede the 65 eventually. And it was Jack Prendergast that had to go all the way back. Now, we've been saying about the long ball puck-out strategy wasn't working. They weren't getting an awful lot of change. The short ball doesn't seem to be working either.
Well, this is the thing, you see. Limerick press so hard, they work so hard. The strength of Hegarty, Lynch's hand so quick there again. They could have tapped up all over the bar as well. And instead, they try to work it in for a goal. You can sense it that they feel there's goals in them, but their physical power is massive.
And you have to give great credit to Limerick because their forwards are working so hard. They are putting pressure on the Waterford defenders.
Massive hunger right throughout the team. You can sense it out there from 1 to 15.
Dermot Burns. Patrick's well, man. Didn't quite connect his normal standard. Waterford were being fouled inside the large rectangle. I think Seamus Flanagan is the one that the referee is pointing to. So Waterford will be happy to relieve the pressure here. Referee blows the whistle after 19 minutes in terms of a water break. But, you know, we've had what? 12 points scored. But for me, the highlight has to be this brilliant, inventive play by Limerick and a fantastic stop by Stephen O'Keefe from Kyle Hayes. And here comes the rebound. And he's there again.
Yeah, that's the one, you know, with bouncing. Just see it in real time. That slow motion. Watch it in real time. That's an incredible save. But this one off the ground. You know, it was a brilliant passage of play. This man, we've been talking about him all year, Marty, Kyle Hayes. He might as well be playing centre forward because he's able to travel that ground. I watched him off the ball making that run to support Keane Lynch there. He ran 80, 90 yards to pick up the ball off his shoulder. Waterford aren't playing that bad. It's just the power of Limerick. They're so intent, their intensity, they're just, you can see their hunger for the game. That's what you should have in an Ireland final. But the physical power in the 50-50 balls, they're winning the ball back all the time. But Waterford, you know, they have time between now and half time. We've seen the momentum after every water break this year changing, and they'll be looking to maybe, you know, close that gap to maybe 1 or 2 by half time. They won't want it to go the other way.
But you have to give great credit as well, Michael, to Limerick. They're powerful in the half back line. There's a good aerial shot of what Croke Park looks on All-Ireland final day 2020. There's nobody here. But you know what? We're intrigued by this wonderful game of hurling in this All-Ireland final. Limerick leading by 4. I was just giving praise to Limerick. Their half-back line, their half-forward line are really powerful.
They are. And look, Waterford are starved of possession. Like they're only 4 down. They had a great goal chance themselves, maybe, and Limerick had as well. But Limerick, really on the balance of play, you reckon, should be further ahead. But Waterford hanging in there.
Free taken by Stephen O'Keefe. Kyle Hayes back defending now, having had his rasper of a shot saved by the Waterford keeper. Shane McNulty is without his hurling. Picking it up is Graham Mulcahy. Here's Ian Kenny. He's done well since coming in for Shane Fives in the Munster final. And the referee has now halted play for an injury to Tadhg Na Bhfirca. Just seems to be in trouble here. And he recovered from injury earlier, of course. This season took a while for him to get back. And if he departs the arena, the Daisha are in big, big trouble. Just have a look at it here. See there. I can see what happened. And it's another painful one. He's holding his knee. Let's see what happens. He just slipped there.
He just lost his foot. And look, in fairness to Croke Park, Marty, all the matches that we've had over the last number of weeks, huge rain overnight with the Camogie final, the John McDonough final over the last 24 hours as well. So the ground conditions holding up very well. We haven't seen many players slipping at all, but his knee went from under him there.
I think if I can lip read, I think he just said he'll be back. A bit like Arnold Schwarzenegger. Meanwhile, Éireann Daly is warming up along the sideline. And Liam Cahill is going to introduce him. Éireann is from Lismore. This is a very young hurler. Played Harty Cup with CBC in Cork in 2019. He's now a student in UCC. Going to hear a lot more about him, but the concern is more about Tadhg Na Bhfirca as well. I think he's going to get strapped up and meet the medical team. At least that's what we hope. Or is that a permanent arrangement?
No, it looks like he's gone. I think he realised himself how serious it was, and even though he walked off reasonably well, he's gone up into the stand.
Gathered by Kyle Hayes. If that is the case, Michael, that is a huge blow to Waterford to lose Tadhg Na Bhfirca after 21 and a half minutes.
It's a massive blow, Marty. He's their key man, really, in terms of defensive strategy. Éireann Daly, great hurler. Here's a high hurling around the neck there. We'll probably see the first yellow card of the game, but the work has influenced massive on Waterford, and for Daly to come in, this early in an All-Ireland final is tough for him because he hasn't got many championship minutes this year at all.
Yellow card for Jamie Barrett. Barry Nash with the free. Good work by Jack Fagan. Just took a little bit too much out of it. Nicely picked up by Cian Lynch. Easily gathered by Stephen O'Keefe. Éireann Daly gets his first touch. You can see that he has a touch of class. Nice little jink. Going for a score from way out the field. The umpires are not too happy as the ball is wide. Off the stick of Jamie Barrett. Quick puck out for Kyle Hayes. William O'Donoghue. Garrod Hegarty. And one senses that Limerick are now in control as Garrod Hegarty raises his first white flag in the All-Ireland final.
Yeah, see Will O'Donoghue looking up there. Look at Hegarty, that's what he does so well. He just drifts away. He's supposed to be right half forward. He's in the left corner forward position and he taps it over the bar.
Shane McNulty sending it down the middle. First touch by Éireann Daly had to be right, and it was. Good connected by Kevin Moore. Drop it down towards Dan Morrissey. Master of all he surveys. Dermot Burns trying to recover. Austin Gleeson has the slither. Surely he's being held. He tries to make an angle. Takes a shoulder. He's fully recovered. Comes back past Jack Fagan. Look how many Limerick green and white jerseys are around the Waterford player with possession. Long ball up towards Seamus Flanagan. Attacking the ball is Shane McNulty. Good play. He's lost his hurley again. Fair play to him. Fires Kevin Moran. Two De La Salle clubmen. Two Waterford hurlers.
Yeah, and Marty, your comment on it there. Look how hard it is for Waterford to get away. The pressure, I thought Austin Gleeson might have been fouled there as well. But four Limerick men around him, and eventually Jack Fagan put under pressure, pucks it into the loose man. Dan Morrissey at full back, you think he was there all his life, just went back there this year. What a year he's having, the way he's grown into that position. And you saw there again Seamus Flanagan fighting for the ball. Garrod Hegarty, there's nobody being let out.
Just a referee having a word with Seamus Flanagan, and Shane McNulty was happening off the ball. And to his credit, Fergal Horgan referee from Tipperary is giving them a stern warning.
I was watching it actually. Shane McNulty, good corner back play before the ball came, and Seamus Flanagan not too happy, so nothing too nasty.
I like the way you say that, Michael, because you say it with a smile as well. Yeah.
Well, I've been down there, and I know what a good cornerback is and what he's capable of.
Here comes Stephen Bennett, just inside his own 45-metre line. It's tailing to the right. There's a connection, but it's too late. Ball is wide. Nicky Quaid has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Limerick hurlers available for the short puck out. Like, Waterford will have to push up on them, Michael.
They have to, Marty, and they're also comfortable on the ball. And here's the overlap again with Hayes.
Kyle Hayes surging forward. He steps away. He knows it's over the bar. Kyle Hayes from Kildymo Palace Skenry, Young Hurler of the Year 2018, has now scored his first point in the All-Ireland Final, having scored, what, 3 times against Clare. One Waterford man. It happens to be Desi Hutchinson. I keep saying it. I can see 5, 6 Limerick players surrounding one Waterford man. They get it out. There's a chance. Jack Prendergast giving it first. The right man, Bennett, stopped on its way to Nicky Quaid. It's still there, cutting across to the centre. They're queuing up, trying to pick it up. It's Jamie Barron. Kyle Hayes is beside him. He's gone out over the end line, but still the slither is alive. Ball comes back outside towards Kieran Bennett, good defending by Limerick, and out over the sideline. Had to be put down as a real scoring opportunity.
Yeah, brilliant block by Dermot Burns there. He came in across. He just kept the eye on the ball. Great skill. Just a hunger again there for Burns to get there. This is a chance now for Austin Gleeson. But you just feel Waterford just needs something to happen for them. You know, if a ball, stick a ball in the net, Limerick are just tipping along and building a lead.
I love that camera angle from the Cusick stand side as Austin Gleeson does what Joel Canning did a few weeks ago. Just sheer, utter class. Watch this. Beautiful. Ah. Limerick back in the attack. Running on past Aaron Galan. Conor Prunty gives it short for his Neil Montgomery. Playing it down the wing. That's better from Waterford. Putting on the brake. And the gas, stepping up a gear. Flicking it forward with the bus. Of the hurling in for is Jamie Barron. There's 3 Limerick players around him. Manages to get it outside. There's a chance here for Kieran Bennett. It's gone. Is it inside? It is. Great score, Kieran Bennett. And Waterford, Dadesha had to work so hard for this. Is it inside? Yes, it is.
Yeah, Marty, great response there. You see, Jack Prendergast, he's a great, hard-working corner forward. Wins the ball into Barron. Pressure again from 3 Limerick lads, but squirted out to Bennett, and he stuck it just inside the post.
Good block down. Sideline is going to Limerick.
Munster final, Barry Nash picked up nearly every puck out off Nicky Quaid. He worked it up that wing and he's doing the same today. You mentioned it a couple of minutes ago. They have to push up and stop. He's too good a hurler to let him dictate from corner back, and that's what he's able to do. It's a big change from the way hurling used to be played, but he's a natural wing back. He can play anywhere.
That's not a good picture for Waterford fans to see one of their greatest, Tadhg Na Bhfearsa. And it's a serious concern for Liam Cahill. That having been said, I have to compliment Earla Daly, who's been introduced. He's only a young fella, but everything he's touched so far, like now, has worked. And he's the confidence and a swagger and a nice sidestep to get past his opponents. Freedom Waterford took a while, but they got there.
But you have to say, Marty, Waterford's response since Tadhg Na Bhfearsa went off, as you mentioned earlier, Dale, he's been rock solid since he came in. They've scored the last couple of times. They have another chance here now and really have played themselves back into the game.
Stephen Bennett, that is his own 65-metre line there. Taking it and sending it straight on target. Never in any doubt. Native of Ballingarry, Liam Cahill guided his own county to minor under-20 and under-21 All-Ireland success. Can he possibly do this for Waterford? Right now, Limerick are on the attack with Tom Morrissey, and the umpire will go for the flag, and that's his third, all from play. He worked hard to get the puck out, made a bit of space, and from literally along the sideline.
He makes it look easy. He actually looked for that puck out. I saw Nicky Quaid looking at him. He went in behind, looked for the puck out and caught it and stuck it over the bar.
Stalemate again, just outside the Limerick 45. William O'Donoghue comes charging in, gets it down for his Garrod Hegarty, lays it back for his Declan Hannan. Short little dink of a pass for his Keane Lynch. Here comes the Waterford charge. That's what Limerick have been doing to Waterford, so in one way it's good to see that Waterford can do it as well, to see if they can play themselves back into this All-Ireland final. Long ball up towards Desi Hutchinson and Neil Montgomery. Declan Hannan laying it off. Tom Morrissey puts it into the space. It's a beautiful ball for Aaron Gillard to run onto. That is just quality hurling. Brilliant play by Limerick.
But Marty, you mentioned him there in the play again. Tom Morrissey, look where he was this time. He's just after scoring from the far side of the field on the sideline. He's back there working, wins the ball and plays a great ball into Galana. Brilliant first touch, and that's a class score.
Well won by Jack Fagan. Frontal charge as Jack Prendergast ran into Garrod Hegarty, or vice versa, depending on where you're from.
Well, that's Limerick's argument there, that he actually ran into him and... Yeah, well, look, it's a frontal tackle, it's a foul. But look at the size of Hegarty and just the impact of that hit.
It looked like a frontal charge.
It is a frontal charge. The tackle's so hard, the tackle in such numbers, they are giving away a number of frees. This will be the five from Bennett now if he scores it. And it's keeping Waterford ticking along.
Just a few metres in from the sideline. It's looking good, never in any doubt. He really is superb on the frees. You know, despite Limerick outplaying Waterford in this first half, the Daisha hopes and dreams are still alive. Since the water break, Limerick and Waterford have shared 8 points evenly between them, four each. Kyle Hayes. Just outside the Waterford 45. This one is wrong side of the post. Third wide of the match for Limerick. Limerick forwards push up on Stephen O'Keefe's puck outs, but Waterford don't do that. They cut out to midfield, and it's giving more options to Limerick. Dermot Burns. Sweet ball down towards Aaron Gillan. Left unchecked, left unmarked on the 45-metre line. It's straight in through. It's his fifth point of the game. But the marking here by Waterford, has to be said, is quite poor.
It was, but a great ball by Dermot Burns. But again, Garrod Hegarty, he's run off the ball. He took two men away from Gillan, and that's why he had so much space when he picked it up.
Short puck out. Kevin Moran trying to get away from Tom Morrissey. Ball inside is a bit of a hospital pass. He's never going to the sunny southeast. Limerick have it. Darragh Donovan to Garrod Hegarty to yet another point for Limerick. They are so good.
Well, it's an incredible display so far from a brilliant team, Marty. Over the last 3 years, the hurling they've done has been savage. But again, the awareness of Darragh Donovan to know Hegarty was there. They're doing the right thing with the ball nearly all the time. Once Kyle Hayes had a shot that maybe he shouldn't have had, and that's it.
And Garrod Hegarty and Tom Morrissey are doing a lot of damage. Between them, they've now scored 5 points from play.
Yeah, and we saw it here the last day against Galway as well. In the Munster final, Waterford did pretty well on them, but the full forward line went to town that day. So, you know, they're so multi-talented, this whole Waterford or Limerick forward line, and it's very hard to keep any of them down.
Keeping Waterford alive is this man, Stephen Bennett, with his frees that have been unerring so far. They stay in touch. Limerick 14, Waterford 9. Just a few minutes of added time.
Limerick 12 points in play, Waterford 2 points in play so far.
Tom Morrissey. Those puck outs from Nicky Quaid are just so good. Darragh Donovan, having received the pass from Tom Morrissey, is just a little bit off target. Fourth wide for the Munster champions. Kevin Moran looked like he was fouling. His ball actually just hit off his boot. Shane McNulty came in to relieve the pressure. And Limerick take the free quick. Keen Lynch into the centre towards Gerard Hegarty. Jamie Barron. Down towards Jack Fagan. Shoulder to shoulder. Kyle Hayes arrives to make sure he doesn't get any space. Still Jack Fagan. Can't go through them. Has to go around him. Somehow he got the slither back. And he's fouled subsequently. Well, Jack Fagan comes from County Meath originally. And certainly his great DNA. His mum is from Connie Shamrocks. And his uncle is Dermot Healy, who trained Offaly back in 1981.
I didn't know that. He worked really hard there, didn't he, to win that free back. Dermot Burns was a great tackle, and then Kyle Hayes coming in, he withstood all challenges and won the free. And that's one thing Limerick will be going to be very disappointed. This is seven frees now that have been scored by Stephen Bennett, and that's, you know, Limerick cut out the fouling. They're dominating this game, but Waterford's still in. We're 9 down against Kilkenny, remember?
4 points in the game of hurling, as you know, Michael, is nothing, but it doesn't quite reflect how awesome Limerick have been in this opening 35 minutes. Can Waterford come with another score before the break? Desi Hutchinson flicking inside. Gleeson! And he whips it over the bar. That's a little bit better. That inside line of Hutchinson, Gleeson and Prendergast need a supply of ball. You feel that when they do get it, they might ask questions of the Limerick defence.
Yeah, Gleeson, look, he's what a gifted player. He arrived there at full pelt and say, probably going for a goal. I flashed it over the bar. He scored a couple of lovely points now.
Oh, great catch. It's Irla Daly. Sending it down the middle. Here comes that man, Stephen Bennett. Willing to take on the direct opponent. Still Bennett puts him in the air. Stop by Nicky Quaid. Good save by the goalkeeper. From the Effin Club and teacher in Patrick's Well. Very much a contender, I'm sure, for All-Star Keeper. And mind you, Stephen O'Keefe has produced goods today. Anyway, that's for another debate. This is much more important. All-Ireland final day. Here comes Jamie Barron, stopped on this occasion, sideline ball. Quickly taken, given back, and the referee won't allow it. I don't know why. I think the ball was rolling, but anyway, the sideline decision stays with Waterford.
Yeah, I think it was outside the field of play, actually, Marty.
Oh, was it?
A yard outside it. We've said this a couple of times in this first half. Credit to Waterford, Marty, again. Limerick and Patches have just looked immense, but Waterford have kept fighting, and, you know, beginning to get... Early Daly has absolutely played a blinder since he came on. He's making a massive difference to them, and playing an awful lot of ball there.
Austin Gleeson. He's little or no options because they're all around him, as you can see on your screen. Almost prevented, or should have been. And it's Kyle Hayes again. Gives the ball away, however. Caleb Lyons goes for a score. And that just looks outside the post.
Yeah, here's Stephen Bennett looking straight through the way he does it. And a good shot enough, but Nicky Quaid made it look routine. You know, just what a first touch to kill the ball there. Look at that. If that bounced out, it was a tap-in for Jack Fagan, I think, following through. So, great save by Quaid.
Good control by Nicky Quaid. Liam Cowell, as you can see, encouraging his team from the sideline. He knows and he will feel that while they've been outplayed in the opening half, they're still alive. Very much so. Only 3 points down. Goalkeeping by Stephen O'Keefe. Will we ever forget the double save? That's the picture in Croke Park. That's the scoreline at halftime. It's Limerick 14 points, Waterford 11. Lots to talk about after the break.
Championship Hurling, the Clash of the Ash, Helmet and Hurley at the Ready. Centra, proud sponsors of the Hurling Championship.
And it's in the net, and it's scored by Bernard Brogan. Ben Neville. Bang, bang, bang. Lee Keegan steps up to put Mayo in front. free kick to win the All-Ireland.
Dublin take on Mayo in the All-Ireland football final. Saturday at 3:40 on RTE2 and RTE Player.
Bye, Gren.
He has caught something of John's essence in this smoky way.
Hey, Gren.
Hey, darling.
I've got something for us. It's really captured his essence. Don't you think?
Everything you love in one place. Easy.
2020 hasn't been normal. But look at us.
Turn it up, Mary!
This isn't normal. Yeah! This is Hurling to the Core, brought to you by Bord Gáis Energy.
Switch to VHI Healthcare for all the benefits of being with Ireland's number one health insurer. As a VHI member, you can see an online doctor 7 days a week at no extra cost. And get fast access to our member-only VHI Swift Care and VHI Pediatric Clinics for as little as €200 per month for two adults and two kids. Call VHI Healthcare today.
Bad Boy, the new masculine fragrance by Carolina Herrera.
Boom shakalaka, all the people them want. Woman them a flex and the man them a chant.
Wind your body, wrinkle your belly.
Africa. Snow ready for Christmas.
Championship is back.
Championship.
Championship. It's championship.
Championship is just different. It's the big day.
This year is our year.
The big moment. We all have different styles.
Really know yourself. Don't touch the bags.
Our own philosophies.
It's all about creating space.
Deep down, we all just love our counties.
I love me county.
And we love our game. We can't explain it. It's a part of us. It's
championship.
Where style meets substance. Little Woods, Ireland.
As we approach Christmas, Lidl would like to assure you that we're making our stores a safe environment for all. With in-store sanitization, Perspex till guards, priority hours for elderly and vulnerable, and more. We ask that customers wear suitable face coverings and use contactless payment where possible. Wishing a safe and happy Christmas to our valued customers and incredible staff from everyone at Lidl.
Little Woods Ireland, proud sponsor of the GAA Hurling Championship.
Half time in an end-to-end All-Ireland hurling final. Seven different scores for Limerick and three different ones for Waterford. Could tell one story, and yet only 3 points in it. 14 points for Limerick, 11 to Waterford. Aaron Galan, the leading scorer at the moment. Okay, well, you did tee it up that goals you expected and that you had expected both teams would be going for them, and we saw that from the very, very beginning. And both teams probably will be disappointed they don't have one, Anthony, or Donalogue.
Yeah, there's been a huge amount of goal-scoring opportunities, Joanne. Early days, we see this. Cian Lynch started the game like he was going to have one of those marquee performances. But here you see himself and Hayes. Both of them almost carrying the ball, 70, 80 yards between him. Lynch sees him. He almost delays the hand pass on purpose. It's a fantastic save from Stephen O'Keefe, albeit a nice height. But the second one is an outstanding save. Any ball that's bouncing down there in front of you. To be fair, Hayes isn't the best finisher in the world, and it is a good Hayes or a good height for a top-class keeper, but that second save was absolutely outstanding. We were debating here whether there was an opportunity for Cian Lynch. Anthony felt strong on it, that maybe there was an opportunity to dummy and him taking it himself.
So to catch it.
But take nothing away, especially from the second Stephen O'Keefe save, was outstanding.
And I think Cian should have shot the second one. I know it would have looked brilliant if he had doubled on it, but he actually, if he could
caught it, he would have buried it in from there.
You could argue that Waterford had more goal chances. We think they had four in total, but three where they really probably would be upset they didn't manage to convert.
We wonder, would they go for it? And since that Munster final, they've been really taking it on. So they've worked the ball very well. I think here it was on to Jack Fagan. You're very early in the match. You know, great pass. Montgomery, and they were looking for the goal. Look at this shot, it just whizzed past Nicky Quaid. We thought he touched on it first of all. Again, here with the Waterford winning the ball, Stephen Bennett. His first thing is go for the goal. Onto Jack Fagan, Neil Montgomery running off the shoulder again. This is another excellent save. Standard goalkeeper hasn't been brilliant this year, goalkeeping, but again, an excellent save by Nicky Quaid there. And this is the last one here, it was a bit of a smuzzle. Again, Waterford, once they break the lines here, their first thing is go. They're travelling on the shoulder again, Stephen Bennett, but again, excellent defending, and the standard of the game has been brilliant. Just brilliant block by Dermot Burns there.
We've had this unbelievable battle between Aaron Gillan and Conor Brundy, and Gillan ends up with 3 points from play in one half, and then Tom Morrissey, who was man of the match the last day, from the very, very off, he had a big role to play.
It's like watching Limerick in full flow with some of the stuff they're doing here, like some of the points over the shoulder. There's very little Kevin Moore or Conor Prunty were doing wrong if you were trying to coach a young fella. I mean, this is outrageous. It gets blocked down and yet has enough on the shot to get it over the bar. This is probably his best point because he calls for the puck out. It bounces up. He gets it back. Makes a bit of ground over on the touchline. Look, following on from his semi-final performance, 5 from play. And Gillan and Prunty are having a massive battle inside. You'd say Prunty is on top at times, but it's very hard to keep Gillan down. He'll keep at you and catch on. You know, makes angles for himself where other people just can't see them. And
this is ridiculous, Anthony, wasn't it? On the bad side out in the corner. It was right under us. Like, it was just a ridiculous score.
And again, like, all was that angle ball to him. Out in front, over the shoulder. It's murder for defence, isn't it?
Yeah, and one of the key things, Joanne, in the first half has been puck outs. To be honest, we didn't speak enough about it before the match, but Limerick have had 12 puck outs. They got six scores off it. They're starting from there, and they're just a transition of the ball. But again, we're up close here to the two boys. The battle that's going on between Prunty and Gran is brilliant.
Burns took his time. He could see Hagerty making a run in behind the defence there. It was nearly a ball for Hagerty. Gillan ended up getting it, but it was the dummy hand pass off his right and in the score. Top class.
Okay, well, the three lads have mentioned, three Waterford men, Cian Lynch, Tom Morrissey and Aaron Gillan, or three Limerick men, should I say, but they are only leading by 3 points at the break. And of course, Henry in particular, and everybody knows what happens the last time Waterford found themselves behind in a big championship game. The second half is coming up next.
That's it.
Come on, Leeson! Come on, Leeson! Come on, Leeson!
Now, Paddy, we've got to milk the cows.
When you speak of legend, you can equate that to Christy Ray.
On one level, an ordinary man. On another level, an extraordinary one.
From the makers of the acclaimed series, The Game.
He had become like O'Cullen, like something out of the Arthurian fables.
They've come from far and wide to see Christy Ray.
The story of Christy Ring is an extraordinary story.
Told through previously unseen and unheard archive footage.
When I started out playing hurling, I had one thing in mind, was to be better than anybody else.
Christy Ring, Man and Ball, Thursday at 10:15 on RTÉ1 and RTÉ Player.
Make someone's Christmas with amazing gifts from Three's online store. Like the Huawei FreeBuds Pro, the Huawei Watch Fit, the Google Nest Hub for home connections, and the Polaroid One Step Plus for making memories. Get the best ever gifts from Three, the network with 5G in every county. Three, make it count.
2020 hasn't been normal, but look at us. This isn't normal. Yeah! This is Hurling to the Core, brought to you by Bord Gáis Energy.
I've been wearing football shorts and a gold chain all year. Haven't even played since secondary. Am I on the naughty list?
Not a sin in our book.
Bring the legs over. I've been faking Pilates for months now. Surely I'm on the naughty list.
after the year you've had. Go on.
For us, no one belongs in the naughty list this Christmas. Tesco, every little helps.
Christmas from 7-Up. The perfect tasty twist this festive season.
Championship is back.
Championship.
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 Championship is just different. It's the big day.
This year is our year.
The big moment. We all have different styles.
Do you know yourself? Don't touch the fact.
Our own philosophies.
It's all about creating space.
Deep down, we all just love our counties.
I love my county.
And we love our game. We can't explain. It's a part of us. It's just...
It's Championship.
Where style meets substance. Little Woods, Ireland.
A collision involving two cars near Port Arlington in County Leash.
The day our lives was shattered.
Worst day of my life.
I didn't realise I would never see him again. The other driver was drunk.
Championship Hurling, the Clash of the Ash, Helmet and Hurley at the ready. Centra, proud sponsors of the Hurling Championship.
Tonight, it's Jackie Tyrrell, Ursula Jacob and Donal Logue, who's done Sunday game from 9:30. On Thursday night, Christy Ring, Man and Ball, celebrates one of the greatest exponents of hurling. That's at 10:15 on RT1. Many of Ireland's top international riders will be among a star-studded field competing in the Show Jumping Masters on Friday. Live coverage here on RT2 from 6:30. And then next Saturday, the 19th of December, it's the fourth All-Ireland football final meeting of Dublin and Mayo in just 8 years. Throw in, as at 5 o'clock, we are on air from 3:40. Oh, what a beautiful evening it is here in Croke Park. Limerick leading 14 points to 11 against Waterford. Waterford, though, scored 111 in the third quarter against Kilkenny in the All-Ireland semi-final. And one of the men leading that charge was Austin Gleeson. And when he managed to get his hand on the ball today...
And you'd say he isn't in a whole pile, but what he has done has been very productive. Like, and if you're in that Waterford dressing room now, you're saying, Ozzy, come on, this is your time. You know, you've been waiting for this half an hour to unfold in front of your eyes. And, you know, great point from distance earlier. Fantastic line ball over the height of the post. And again, the movement here, you see him coming into picture, continues his run. He's not tracked well enough, gets it, maybe half a chance of a goal, but blazes it over the bar. And you're buying him up now if you're in there, if you're Liam Cahill. You're saying you're on your song here, kid. Go for it now.
One of the things, interesting things that Liam Cahill said after that Kilkenny win was he talked up the S&C coach, the strength and conditioning. How important is that going to be today? Because we all know the way Limerick work and the way they go right till the end. Are Waterford able to keep up with that all the way?
Well, look, the obvious thing is we're going to know that in 35 minutes. I'm not so sure. In the first half, at times, it looked as if Limerick were going to totally overpower Waterford. It was almost like Waterford were just trying to keep a candle lighting in against the monsoon. But they stuck in there. I think goals are still their only hope. I can't see them outscoring Limerick from a point scoring.
Four goal chances in the first half.
Exactly, and that's one of the reasons why they're going after it, but they'll have to get them, Joanne. If they don't get them, in my head as well, it was like watching a film and wondering how are they surviving this long, and are they going to survive the second half? I'm not so sure.
Henry, sorry.
I think they're surviving because Limerick are giving away frees. We talk about their work rate, but they are, Waterford, Bennett has got 8 points from frees, you know, so, and Austin Gleeson obviously as well, but Tadhg Na Bhfearsa going off was a big loss, we thought, but Éirlí Daoine, early, it's very, very well since he's come in.
But that still leaves Limerick with a stronger bench now, Joanne. If you know, Casey has to be unloaded, the Pat Ryans, the Adrian Breens. Waterford already have lost the key man in Tadhg, so it's advantage Limerick. But I still think that in that Waterford dressing room now, they'll be saying, this is it. This against, is the chance.
Yeah. And against Kilkenny, when they got those goals, there were huge boosters to them. They were even worth more than the 3 points. But it's still, from my point of view, it's still hard to see Limerick losing this one.
Henry, I know that you find it very strange that Cian Lynch moved from centre-forward.
Yeah, I know they're moving around, but definitely he was positioned there and he was causing untold damage the first quarter. But he seems to have moved further out the field and even tracking towards midfield. So I get him in closer to the goal because they weren't able to handle him at the beginning.
I'm having a look. He actually looks like he is in the centre-forward position for this second half, but of course he's not staying in one place for too long.
I tell you, Joanne, Kyle Hayes is like another orthodox wing forward. He's just bombing up that wing, that left-hand side. They've just, Anthony showed it a bit before the match. He's just been immense. I'd love to know how many possessions he would have had in that first half.
And the Cian Lynch one, Kevin Moran, they lined up together early days, and it definitely looked after the first quarter that Kevin Moran was getting way tighter on him. It'll be very interesting to see, is that the way it starts here, and is that what's actually taking Cian Lynch out of the game, Henry?
Okay, it is so finely poised as this second half is about to get underway. So let's head back to our commentary team for the 2020 All-Ireland Hurling Final, Michael and Marty.
Thank you very much, Joanne. In the previous meetings, Limerick beat Waterford in the league and in the Munster final by 4 points. Just 3 points between the teams now, but there's a huge, the biggest prize of all, the Liam McCarthy Cup. The symbol of All-Ireland success is at stake. We have to have a result here in Croke Park this afternoon. So let's see. In the past, Waterford have always come good in the second half. Let's see, can they do the same? 9 points down against Kilkenny. And we all remember their display then. They've lost Tadhg Na Buarcha, but I have to give credit again to Erla Daly from Lismore. He's been outstanding. 3 points between the teams.
Yeah, loose hurling by Garrett Hegarty. I think very lucky to get away without a yellow card there. Stephen Bennett just recovering there. It was actually him that was fouled there and winning the free. Just one thing about Callum Lyons and Kevin Moran. Kevin Moran is picking up Morrissey here. He's playing right half back. And Lyons is on Hegarty. I think they're both out of position. Lyons is a totally, to me, the way he hurls, the way he's right-handed, he's much happier on the right side. Kevin Moore is completely left-sided, and I think there's a much better balance to the half-back line if they switch back.
Stephen Bennett with the fray, and that's his first miss. It was a long way out, to be fair, but it's still a bit of a psychological blow because every point and every free he takes, he normally puts it between the posts. Let's see, what can Waterford do in the second half? Can Limerick reproduce what they did in the opening 35 minutes? Jamie Barron has gone back to help out his defence. Available, calling for it is Kevin Moore. Whips it down into the Waterford full forward line. Opportunity here, Barry Nash comes in to pick up the loose slither, beating Desi Hutchinson to it on that occasion. Calling for it in front of the Hogan is Darrow Donovan. Lovely stick work again. Kyle Hayes. Spreading it wide over towards Seamus Flanagan. Staying with him is Shane McNulty. Flanagan over the shoulder sends that between the posts.
Yeah, Marty, that was just a brilliant score. Again, Barry Nash wins a great ball back in his own full back line, but he worked it out, and Kyle Hayes' ball across to Flanagan, just fantastic, and an easy score. Made look easy, but a brilliantly worked score.
Jack Prendergast sending ball up towards Desi Hutchinson, but the Limerick defence resume where they were in the first half. And winning those 50-50 balls. Kyle Hayes getting a shoulder on this occasion from Austin Gleeson. Seamus Flanagan comes across. He's already scored 2 points, one in each half. Both of them over his shoulder. Aaron Gillan is sending this in, but just to the left and right. Stephen O'Keefe taking a short puck out. As Waterford go long in this second half. But there's three Limerick defenders to one Waterford attacker up. Darrow Donovan, nice little sidestep. Sending it over towards Tom Morrissey. Little flick over, nice hand pass for Garrod Hegarty. 10 and 12, they understand each other. They play well with each other in a half-forward line that is continuing to impress. That is Garrod Hegarty's third point of the match, and between them, they've scored six.
Yeah, and they're changing again. Tom Morrissey in at centre half forward there now. And look, simple stuff, Marty. That's simple, but it's using the head, doing the right thing. In and out, and final under pressure. That's what makes an awful difference.
Jamie Barron, he did well almost to pull down to control. Cian Lynch thought he was going to be hooked. And there's a challenge by Jack Prendergast on the Patrick Swell man. And referee Fergal Horgan immediately blew the whistle and is given a free. This is the reason why. Just catching Cian Lynch on the ear. No doubt about the foul. This is a great score by Seamus Flanagan. He did this in the first half down at the Davin end. He's now done it on the Hill 16 end.
Yeah, look, and last year he lost out on his starting place to Peter Casey, who was playing superbly, and Peter Casey brilliant in the Munster final this year as well. Just the strength that they have, but Flanagan stuck to his guns and has won his place back on merit, his pace and his power, but he's also able to, you know, he's two lovely points. And he's a great out for the half back line. He's always on the move and having a fine game again today.
See, Darren Lyons is warming up. Scored a great goal against Kilkenny. Might be required again, something similar. Particularly when Aaron Gillan is taking a free that is well within his range. Another white flag raised. That's his 6th point of the match.
Yeah, powerful start to the second half. Marty by Limerick, you know. First 3 scores of the second half now, but they're dominating possession. Waterford trying to go along, it hasn't worked for them. You know, Limerick dropping the man back there and picking up all the breaking ball back around their own full back line. So here we are again, 3 lads closing in the ball.
Darren Lyons just on there for Kieran Bennett, just to confirm that. Good work by Caleb Lyons, but he's surrounded by 4 Limerick players. Still, they have the possession, calling for this Seamus Flanagan. Good wrist work, and then floats this in, and floats it between the posts. He may be a big, tall man, but he's got great wrists, because just watch this. Control, balance, shot, score. Fantastic.
Yeah, that was great work. We saw Limerick closing in on the ball. Graham Mackay eventually won it. And just that little dink over the top. But Flanagan gave him the option by running 70 yards out the field again to take that pass off him. And great piece of skill there by Austin Gleeson, bringing down that puck out. And he was clipped by Barry Nash. And much needed score here now should come from Stephen Bennett.
Going for his 8th point of the match. Squeezes inside the far over post. And that gives Waterford a little bit of hope again. 3 points down at the break, and now trailed by 6. Seamus Flanagan was well pleased with the points, and rightly so. Darragh Lyons is the 23. Tom Morrissey is the number 12. Ball inside Prescott Road. Hegarty bearing down on goal. Decided not to test out Stephen O'Keefe again. And scoop that over the bar for his 4th point of the game.
Well, one of the front runners for Hurler the year before today, and what a game Hegarty's having. But again, Tom Morrissey, selfless. Went up under the puck out, knocked it down, but had the power back to roll, lift it into his hand, and then pick out Hegarty off his shoulder. 7 between them now, and they're running riot, the two of them.
Ball is aimed at Austin Gleeson. Has the slither, he's taken 3 Limerick players with him. Still Gleeson, didn't quite connect. It could still work out okay for Waterford. Neil Montgomery is trying hard. Limerick are powerful in defence. Darragh O'Donovan is given a free. Challenged by Austin Gleeson, who is visibly frustrated.
Yeah, and it's just Limerick trying to do the right thing again here. Just high tackle in there to Darragh O'Donovan. But Barry Nash, most players would drive that ball long down the field, but has the presence of mind to pick out O'Donovan. He was just looking to turn back inside for a man coming off the shoulder again. It's just, they're so comfortable on the ball right throughout the field.
Limerick in the start of the second half have scored 5 points, one response from Waterford. And they certainly are under pressure today. Kevin Moore comes dashing down the field, trying to set up Desi Hutchinson. But Sean Finn is rock solid. All-star cornerback 2018 and 19, and you can see why. Great little shimmy by Declan Hannan. Hannan has gone for the return pass, but again it's the Morrissey-Hegarty combination that is killing Waterford. Their understanding, their ability to find each other is just top notch.
It's unbelievable. But where that started from, Sean Finn, a cornerback, what a hurling cornerback to come out, win that low ball, and then work it up the field, and trip Declan Hannan and Morrissey linking up again with Hegarty, and it's just phenomenal hurling. In full flow, they're just unplayable.
John Kiley. Is he going to lead Limerick to their second All-Ireland success in 3 years. Right now, they look in control. Can Desi Hutchison change the landscape on the scoreboard? He can. That's a much better quality ball. It's his first point in this All-Ireland final, coming after almost 44 minutes. But it's the ball that went inside was quality. It gave him a chance to gather it and turn and score.
Yeah, brilliant player, very exciting player, and a great addition to the Waterford team. Not getting that much ball, but Sean Finn is so tight. I think Hutchison got a point early on in the Munster final. That was it then. After that, Finn closed up shop and took an exceptional catch there from himself to make the room to put that one over.
Conor Gleeson on for Neil Montgomery as Liam Cahill makes the changes to try and revise his side. Brilliant catch by Keane Lynch. Inside in first, Tom Morrissey uses the short grip, and the slither is once again flying between the posts and over the bar. Between them, the Hegarty and Morrissey duo, they've now scored 9 points, all from play.
Yeah, and Lynch making it all happen in there as well. You know, what a vision he has. He's totally unselfish and threw that one out again.
Kevin Moore looking to see what are the options. He goes for the score from way out the field. He hasn't scored since the opening of the Munster Championship game for Waterford against Cork. Now he notches his second of the Championship.
Yeah, what a warrior for Waterford over the years. One of the greats ever. Has played everywhere for them, totally selfless. I think it's Seamus Flanagan picking up a yellow card there, but Kevin Moore there and Desi Hutchison, two inspirational points, I would say. They're seven down. They need their big men to stand up now. The Barons, the Gleesons, to get into the game and give them a dig out here.
Ball is won by Waterford on this occasion. Again, physical presence. Kyle Hayes. Bursting forward, still Kyle. He's now inside the Limerick half of the field and he's still going strong. Ball comes out towards Darragh Donovan. Good work by Austin Gleeson. Loses possession, however. Mad scramble. Caleb Lyons is on the ground and the referee Fergal Horgan from Dundrum and County Tipperary is going to throw this ball in, surely. And he does. Pulled on first time. Early Daly. This is first time any sort of an error, because so far it's been really impressive. Stephen O'Keefe goes for distance, dropping it in around the house, but Limerick are there again in numbers. Good work by Dermot Burns. Ball comes out for his Sean Finn. Got a knock as he was delivering the pass out to Hegarty. Beautiful stick work over for his Dermot Burns. Still Burns heading towards the 20 metre line. Gives himself enough space to swing the hurley, but this time wrong side of the post. Puck out is quickly taken by Stephen O'Keefe. Far more open in the second half now as Caleb Lyons drops this in, dropping from the sky. Is it on target? It is. That is a brilliant score. Caleb Lyons from Ballyduff Lower, hitting an absolute beauty from way out the field.
Yeah, and I mentioned it earlier, he's now right at right half-back, Kevin Moore's at left half-back. Both of them have scored a point in the last couple of minutes. Much more comfortable even in their balance and in their shape playing off that side. And Stephen O'Keefe's puck out much quicker in the second half, giving them more possession.
Nicky Quaid goes for distance. Breaking ball picked up on this occasion by Kevin Moore, who's much more involved, as Michael said, but he's so involved he was deemed to be charging. And it's a soft free to give away to Limerick. But the pressure is always there from Limerick. But when you have a prolific free taker like Aaron Galland, you just can't give away anything soft at all.
Yeah, well, the first half, Limerick's tackling was ferocious. They were giving away an awful lot of frees. Stephen Bennett scored seven. The second half, Bennett has only got one scoreable free, and he scored it. But Limerick have been staying with their men better. They haven't been going in as high with the spare arm, and their discipline has improved. So it's obviously something they looked at half-time, because it was keeping Waterford in the game.
He's already registered 6 points. That's Aaron Gillan. Lifting and striking this. And once again, it's over the bar. 7 points. Good score. Peter Casey is coming on to the Limerick attack. And the player that's going off is Graham Mulcahy. And great servant to Limerick hurling, and certainly was one of the goal scorers in the 2018 All-Ireland final, himself and Tom Morrissey. And Peter Casey has had also a great season, and I'm sure he's going to add a bit of sparkle to that Limerick attack. Darry Lyon trying to get the pass away. Farris, Jamie Barron, Dan Morrissey, Gerard Hegarty. Great block down. Full marks. Caleb Lyon's doing really well as the ball comes over for Austin Gleeson. A little bit of magic from Gleeson now required. He's looking at the post. He decides to flick it in. Dan Morrissey puts up the hurl. Declan Hannan, and they work themselves out of trouble. Peter Casey gets his first touch, calling for it in front of the Hogan as Gerard Hegarty in space. Seamus Flanagan wanted the long ball in, but Gerard Hegarty knew what he was doing, and that is over the bar. This is an awesome display by the wing forward.
Well, it's turned into one of the great All-Ireland final displays, I think, by Gerard Hegarty. 6 from play. He's just turning up everywhere, Marty. How could you mark him? Look at the physique of him, the fitness, the athleticism. Took him a few years maybe to fill into his frame and to really reach his full potential, but what a performance he's given here today.
Short puck out, not quite working. Peter Casey latches onto it. Ian Kenny finds himself under pressure and in trouble, and that is going to be a free in for Limerick.
And that's what you call clever. We were talking about corner back play earlier on, but that's clever corner forward play. He had no real options. He just leaned back in, took him on the inside, and Kenny just got the arm in around him and swung him to the ground.
Question is, what can he do? And that's, I'm sure, is what Liam is saying to Michael Bevans and indeed to his fellow management team. That gives you a greater view of what it's like for Aaron Gallan heading down towards Hill 16. Going for his 8th point of the match. So easy for the Patrick Swell man. Ball batted down. Jamie Barron gets a hand to it, trying to lay it off. But Limerick again are there. Gerard Hegarty just about keeping it in. Backfire is Darrow Donovan. Call came from William O'Donoghue. Pulled on by Barry Nash. Peter Casey. Will cause problems for Waterford, I sense, if he gets a little bit of space. Declan Hannan is in there. Great spirit again by Waterford and Darrell Lyons. 2-2 up here. Waterford need to do something. Perhaps this man can do it. It is Stephen Bennett, and he lashes that over the bar. Good score. That's for his 9th point of the game. Keeps Waterford in touch. But the clock is ticking towards the 70th minute. There's still plenty of time.
There is, Marty. They could have done with a goal there, but it wasn't on. And Stephen Bennett, dead right, just tapped it over the bar.
Liam Cahill will speak to his players. You can see that the players are doing their best to encourage their teammates. But right now, Gerard Hegarty is having a man of the match performance in the All-Ireland final. Himself and Tom Morrissey have scored 10 points from play. 2 wing forwards.
Phenomenal stuff.
And so John Kiley is giving his team a little break. Now you can see there are 34 schools, primary schools, 3,000 children have drawn fans in the stands. A competition, they had thousands of entries, once in a lifetime opportunity, and the fans in the stands comes from school children in Waterford and Limerick, but also in Kerry, Tipperary, Meath, Offaly, Clare, and it's a great and novel idea. Well done to all the children for participating in that. Your presence and what you've contributed to the All-Ireland final day is huge, because when we look across, as we look from the aerial, when we look across, it's empty here at Croke Park, so to see the artistry of our young children is, well, to lift your heart.
Absolutely. I think you see John Milan over there as well in the middle of it. Maybe it's not. No, lovely. It's great artwork, and keeping the two segregated as well, the Limerick and the Waterford crowd.
Second half scores, by the way, just in terms of stats, Limerick have scored 10 times to Waterford's 5. It sums up that third quarter, which has always been more or less good for Waterford, but Limerick took control, and this I mean, if they win the All-Ireland, you'd have to say, my God, do Limerick deserve it, if they can hold on.
And look, they've scored 19 points from play. We're harping on about the two wing forwards, but their lads, you know, Kyle Hayes is a point, Will O'Donoghue is a point. Galan is three from play, and he's not hugely in the game. Seamus Flanagan, three from play as well. So Keane Lynch, pulling all the strings, hasn't scored, but he's thrown the ball around, you know, using his skill and his vision and key man. So, look, it's been a powerful, powerful performance. But you have to say, Waterford have not given up, haven't thrown in the towel. Hard to see a way back, but you never know in hurling.
I'm just about to ask you, how can they do this? They've about, what, 19 minutes to
I think Limerick's defence is just too strong. I can't see anyone breaking them down to that extent.
Well, we're in the final quarter of the All-Ireland Final 2020. Austin Gleeson is fouled. Kevin Warren does a change, actually. Kevin Warren is off. And coming on to the side is the substitute, and that is Patrick Curran, who normally plays corner forward from Dungarvan. Dad, Patrick Curran, played hurling for Waterford for many years from Capaquet. Anyway, back to Stephen Bennett, going to take this free on his own 65. This is straight and true, but it's also inaccurate. Ball is wide. Eight wides Waterford have shot. You can't really criticise Stephen Bennett. He scored nine times, and I think he's missed twice, if I'm not mistaken. Meanwhile, the Limerick display continues on. Nicky Quaid to Barry Nash to Kyle Hayes. Down towards Seamus Flanagan. Little flick on. Fires Aaron Galan. Ball into the centre. Peter Casey. Shimmy to the left. Goes to the right. High challenge. And let's be honest, Waterford are in deep trouble in defence, because Limerick are running at them and certainly causing trouble.
Yeah, and you see Casey again, they're using his experience. He leaned in, but Ian Kenny up high, got a yellow card there. That's two fouls in a row now. And the first half we talked about Limerick's fouling, but Waterford fouling as they come under more pressure now. They've no option but to give away the freeze.
Aaron Galan scores his ninth point of the match. John Kiley, he can calmly watch on now. Great, great catch. That's substitutes, Patrick Curran working hard. Ball in, and unfortunately, despite the best efforts of Jesse Hutchinson, Slither rolls out over the end line. Nicky Quaid taking the puck out a little bit too quickly on this occasion. Has to do it again. Barry Nash is immediately available. He's going for distance, and he's aiming for Garrod Hegarty. Irla Daly comes across to Gather. He's fouled, and that's a free.
Marty, we're talking about the scoring of Limerick, you know, 19th in play. The forward line has started. Austin Gleeson got 2 points from play in the first half. Desi Hutchinson got one in the second half, and Stephen Bennett's got one from play. The 2 points from play in the in either half from your starting forward line is not going to, you know, give you the base that you need. All the Limerick backs looking really comfortable, winning their battles. Desi Hutchinson looking lively, Gleeson at times, but overall Limerick rock solid at the back.
Shane Fives coming on for Ian Kenny a moment ago as Austin Gleeson drops this in and over the bar. Good score. Narrows the gap. There's still time. It's not over till that final whistle, and Liam Cowell and the Waterford hurlers will know it. But they need to just find their rhythm a little bit. Puck out is from Nicky Quaid to Seamus Flanagan. And that one is wide. Stephen O'Keefe in a bit of a hurry, and I wouldn't blame him. Going for distance again. It's three against two down here. Batted down. Nicely picked up by Patrick Curran, who's got on a lot of ball. Wanted to lay it off. He does. To Jack Fagan. Cutting across into the centre. There's a chance here for Bennett. Can he pull the trigger? Nicky Quaid bats it out for his William O'Donoghue. Easy for the Limerick keeper. To Tom Morrissey. Down towards Seamus Flanagan. Aaron Galan comes out. Good block down. Good defending Waterford. Full marks to Conor Prunty on this occasion. Daryl Lyons sending it down for his Austin Gleeson. Can Waterford rescue the situation? Gleeson goes on a run, heading towards the 20, about to be greeted by Kyle Hayes. Austin Gleeson gets the shot in, but the ball sails well wide.
Yeah, maybe he should have hit the ball earlier. You know, when he got it first, he had a better chance. You saw Kyle Hayes just time. There's the chance for the goal. Hit it high again. You know, they have to be low and hard. Nicky Quaid, block, good, you know, good save, but fairly routine for him. But Austin Gleeson there, he saw Kyle Hayes waiting for him and then set him with the shoulder, knocked him off balance in the poor wide.
Long puck out again from Nicky Quaid, who got the last touch. It's going to Waterford. Shane Fives, just introduced, regular corner back for Waterford for many, many years now. Still 14 minutes to go, or thereabouts. Jamie Barron going to take the sideline cut. Thought about cutting it across field to Cusick stand. There were at least two players available. Goes down the right way. Doesn't work out for him, however, as Barry Nash is available. Gives it into the centre towards Kyle Hayes. That diagonal ball continues to pose problems for Waterford. And Aaron Gallan gathers and turns and shoots. Great score.
Well, how many times have we said it? Barry Nash to Kyle Hayes, the long diagonal ball. Now, like, that looks easy, but you have to have everything in the game to do that. Like Aaron Gallan, the balance, the footwork, just turned onto his right. That's his weaker side, but makes no difference.
Great catch, my word. Jack Prendergast. And he has the vision to spot Caleb Lyons. Waterford have to produce something here. Lyons going for it, takes a shot. Oh, Nicky Quaid. Now, that is a good save. The other two might have been straight at him, but we have to credit the Limerick keeper. Fine effort by Caleb Lyons. Scored a goal against Cork, worth a try, but this time Nicky Quaid responded. We stay with the live action. Good work again by Waterford as they try and recover the situation. Ball into the centre. They're giving it everything. You have to give them credit, they're not giving up. As Darryl Lyons again comes bursting forward, lowing, laying it over first. Conor Gleeson from 4 Mile Water. Well won back by Keane Lynch. Little dink in first. Tom Morrissey was trying to knock it down into the path of another player. Indeed, make space for himself. Caleb Lyons drives it in again. Dan Morrissey has the situation under control. Read and anticipated well. Into the centre towards Kyle Hayes. About to be confronted by Austin Gleeson. Short hands for his William O'Donoghue. Over for his Garrod Hegarty. On his own 65, he is playing with such confidence now he can have a go from any angle. But on this occasion, he shows he's human.
It's hard to believe. It's hard to believe he's after doing that. Take him off. But here's Callum Lyons. Look at this for a shot. And Nicky Quaid. We have to say both goalkeepers today. The two saves in the first half. But this is a rocket from well out the field. And there's Nicky Quaid. What a player he is, though, as well, you know, for Limerick. We have all the superstars outfield, but he is so solid. He's a brilliant hurler in the goals, can do everything, and a fantastic servant to Limerick hurling over the years.
Waterford trying everything now. Short ball far as Darryl Lyons. Flicking it on, and Jamie Barron, despite his best efforts, just can't keep it in the white lines. Sideline ball for Limerick.
Yeah, I think they're going to have to get it in. You know, there's only 10 to go. They have to get it in more direct. Two or three little short passes there out around the sideline. That's bread and butter for Limerick, the way they tackle and harry. Try to get it in one-on-one to Hutchinson inside and seeking to get a goal, manufacture a goal.
Barry Nash in the South Liberty slab going to take this sideline cut. Limerick have it again. As they retain the possession, the under pressure Waterford. Austin Gleeson is back there. Good hands for us, Jack Prendergast. David Reedy is in for Limerick, as I mentioned a while ago. Jack Prendergast is fouled. And there's a bit of afters. And that is going to be a free for Waterford. Just around the 45-metre line. With 10 minutes to go, there's a huge gap. But in the game of hurling, of course, one goal can change the complexion. Kyle Hayes has shown a yellow card. Take the point, drop it in. Let's see what Stephen Bennett does. Decision is to take the point. Reduces Limerick's lead slightly. Limerick 26, Waterford 18 now. Declan Hanna. Short ball for us, Garrod Hegarty. David Reedy going for the score from way out the field, and Reedy has just sent this outside the post.
Yeah, lovely move again, and Barry Nash out to Declan Hannan, you know, just playing it through the lines, and Hegarty at centre forward now, they're just moving around it. Waterford half back line just can't keep tabs on the three Limerick half forwards.
That was Limerick's ninth wide, by the way. When you look at the scoreboard, they've scored 26 times and they're not finished yet. Ball dropped down towards Seamus Flanagan. Caleb Lines keeping it down the wing. Nice stick work by Desi Hutchison. He had to, because there were two Limerick defenders beside him. Gives it back to Lines again. That's a good ball, but Barry Nash is coming across to deal with it. Happy to get out of the danger zone. Prevents the 65, although the umpire has his arm outstretched. Barry, I think, is protesting. The umpire felt the ball had crossed the line, so it's going to be a 65. Let's see if it did. It was close.
Don't think so.
Don't think so either.
No, yeah. Definitely kept it in.
Don't think that was a 65. Pat Ryan is now coming on for Limerick. And the player that's going off is Seamus Flanagan, who worked himself back onto the team and certainly has contributed to what looks like now to be an All-Ireland success with 8 minutes to go. Jack Fagan, Desi Hutchison, they have to go for it. Nicky Quaid at his near post wasn't going to be beaten that easily. And Nicky Quaid, as I mentioned, the last day started his career as a midfielder for Limerick and now a top-class goalkeeper, so well able to play out the field. It ends up with David Reedy. Kyle Hayes is behind him if he needs him. And it's a little 1-2, and away goes Reedy. Good use of the hand pass. Declan Hannan was involved. Tom Morrissey shoots, and that ball is wide.
So intricate, though, again, Marty. You know, no panic. Just work it out. Use the hand pass. Play it through the hands. They have the skill level. It doesn't break down. A bad wide at the end of it, but it was still a clear-cut chance that they created from nothing.
Pulled on by Stephen Bennett. Picked up by Austin Gleeson. Jack Prendergast is available, but Gleeson has the skill, has the stick work, and he's also got the point.
Yeah, and I think he deserves massive credit today, Marty, Austin Gleeson. From the first minute, he's shown the proper attitude. He's worked really hard. He scored a few, that's three from play, a line ball, long range free, and he's, you know, his general discipline and overall game has been excellent.
Kyle Hayes is the player that's down injured. Liam Kyle continues to say encouraging words. They're still alive, as we've said all along. That third quarter, however, was dominated by Limerick, and it's Gerard Hegarty bearing down in goal and happy to take yet another point. 7 points from play, number 10. 4 points from play, number 12. 11 points between them. It's just remarkable.
It's unbelievable. Where he caught that ball, he caught it, you know, he let it kind of drop down, caught it around the maybe thigh or knee level, and then had the power to shake off his man. Running out of words at this stage to describe it.
Still concerned about Kyle Hayes. Young hurler of the year just 2 years ago, of course, and has played in minor under 21 All-Ireland finals. And this ball is dropping in, dropping harmlessly wide. Just about 5 minutes to go, and Limerick going to introduce Paddy O'Loughlin from Kilmallock. The Waterford management team just slightly bewildered at the moment, because I think no matter who's playing today, Limerick were going to give a display like this. They're just awesome. Full credit to them. Coming across is William O'Donoghue. Into the centre, Gerard Hegarty, surrounded quickly by four Waterford players. Shane Fives comes away with it. The hard-working Darrell Lyons, and Gerard Hegarty has recovered to flick the ball back once again for his Dermot Burns. Continues to play it down the wing. Aaron Galan, his clubmate from the Well, comes out to gather into the centre. Waterford have it once more. Shane Fives has impressed, so too has Darrell Lyons is being introduced. And once again, Desi Hutchison will chase this. Performing well at top of the right, with little support coming from outside at the moment. Limerick have it again with Kyle Hayes. Masterful display at left half back. Give me an over first, Tom Morrissey. Equally awesome. Good work by Pat Ryan. And Pat Ryan off the post, and did it go over the bar? The umpires are satisfied it did. Pat Ryan will be pleased, so will Limerick. He had to work hard to get away from Shane McNulty and needed the help of the post here to deflect it in between.
Yeah, what a sub to have. The power and pace that man has, you know, and bringing him on when legs are getting heavy and tired. Nightmare for any cornerback.
Darrell Lyons, they continue to feed Desi Hutchinson, who continues to win ball after ball. Into the centre, it's Stephen Bennett trying to break down. William O'Donoghue brings him down. And that is going to be a free, and certainly William O'Donoghue will have to be spoken to here and shown a card for that challenge, because he knew there was a goal-scoring opportunity coming towards Stephen Bennett.
Yeah, and you have to say, we mentioned Austin Gleeson, Desi Hutchinson has shown so well for the ball. Cynical fouler, and Bennett will have no choice now. He'll go for this, and his savage power.
Six Limerick men along the goal line. Stopped by Nicky Quaid. He just bats it out. There is David Reedy. Keeps it down the wing. Down towards Pat Ryan. Shane McNulty staying with him. Scooping it out was Shane Fives, but he just squelched out of his hand. And it's a sideline ball for Limerick.
Well, Limerick pushing towards the 30-point barrier again, Marty. Unimaginable, you know, a few years ago that any team would score that. But Limerick, you know, just with that range of players throughout their team, from anywhere in the half-back line right through to corner forward, can score. There's the high tackle again there by Will O'Donoghue for the free in. But it's incredible scoring. And Aaron Gallan going off injured against Galway, ran into Garrett McInerney and was in hospital that night.
Dermot Burns dropping this over the bar for his first point in the All-Ireland final.
Yeah, and it's a point apiece now for the half-back line, just reinforcing the point I was just making. And, you know, from anywhere from 5 to 15, they're lethal.
Sideline ball going to Waterford. 10 points between the teams. David Reedy trying to scoop it out, but it's Waterford that have the possession with Stephen Bennett, whose heart and determination and character continues to shine despite the scoreline and despite meeting a superior team on the day. Stephen Bennett just inside the Limerick 65, dropping this in. Does it touch? Well, the ball is wide.
Yeah, I read a great piece in the paper yesterday about the Bennetts with their dad, Tat, and three of them played minor on the same day for Waterford, which is some achievement. Shane at home, well capable of being out there as well, and just took a year out this year.
Brilliantly caught by Caleb Lyons. And that's going to be a free for Waterford. Stephen O'Keefe coming out of his goal line to take it. Going to take it quickly. Darrell Lyons from Dungarvan dropping this in. It's two against one, and it's easily dealt with by Sean Finn and company. Out fires Dermot Burns. 3 minutes of additional time has just been announced. 10 points between the teams. Limerick look home and hosed at this stage, and that has also gone to the wrong side of the post. It really is an awesome display. Remember coming into this All-Ireland final, yes, we knew Limerick were going to be the favourites. Yes, they'd beaten Waterford twice already by 4 points. But they just seem to just draw breath and energy from the challenge. And look what they gave here.
That's it. You've kind of had the feeling all year, Martin, this was coming. They've been playing well within themselves. But, you know, in the last 3 years, beaten by Kilkenny here last year by a point in the Ireland semi-final. Outside of that, they've been awesome.
Darrell Lyons trying to drop it in around the house, but there's enough players there between Sean Finn and Dermot Burns to deal with it. Burns gives David Reedy the run, and away he goes. Cutting it across, more accurately, as Tom Morrissey is on fire. 5 points for the hand man. Just an awesome display.
Incredible, Marty. We knew it coming here. Their half forward line was key, and they still scored 12 between them and completely dismantled a very good Waterford half back line.
They've reached 30 points on the scoreboard, and there were still 2 minutes or a minute and a half of injury time. Limerick substitutes, well, Limerick players. See Dara Donovan and Kyle Hayes, John Kiley trying to manage things. Mike Reardon, the Limerick County Secretary there, fully recovered from an ankle injury recently. And Limerick, knowing now that the Limerick is returning to Shannon's side. Although I know that Croke Park have announced that the Cup will not be going. And I think that's a great decision by the GA and by Croke Park, because all the provincial councils have been doing that, because we have to remember we are very much living through this pandemic.
Absolutely. It's been brilliant to have the championship. That was the main thing, and bringing the cup home won't be a big deal for Limerick. Winning is what it's all about. And Marty, just thinking about next year already, these lads go for three in a row with a young, very, very young team, an age profile, and getting better all the time.
Ball into the centre towards Austin Gleeson. There's the slip there behind him. There was a challenge. Soft enough free, I would say, but Fergal Horgan is giving it to Waterford. Austin Gleeson trying to drop it in. Nicky Quaid gets his body behind it. Wasn't going to let in a soft goal at this stage of the championship. Sean Finn. As Limerick worked the ball out, far as Dermot Burns with the pass from Declan Hannan. Burns' effort is dropping in around the house. Oh, great fielding. Superb. Full marks. Shane McNulty, and a good clearance as well. Down far as Darrell Lyons. As Limerick attacked the ball, as Dan Morrissey comes out with it. And Limerick are the All-Ireland hurling champions in this unique, bizarre and strange year. They're unbeaten in the Munster League, the Alliance League, the Championship, League champions, Munster champions, All-Ireland champions. And my word, don't they deserve it. John Kiley has brought them back to the promised land from 1973 to 2018. They were waiting for All-Ireland glory. He got them there, and he's back there again.
Yeah, Marty, I think you have to mention John Kiley. You've mentioned him there. What a job he's done with Limerick. You know, really nice guy. Edge of steel there, obviously, but a huge Limerick man. And you just have to, you know, the way they approach the game, their physical condition and their fitness, but look, their style and their swagger, and you know, 24 points from play out of that 30 says it all about them. They can score from anywhere. They play the ball through the hands from corner back right up the field, and they're so comfortable on the ball, every single one, from the goalie to the corner forward.
And every club in Limerick and every parish, from Adair, Ahan, Doon, Kilmallock, Ballybrown, Clahan, St. Patrick's, Monaline, Moreau, they'll all be celebrating tonight in their home, hopefully safely, because that's important. We need to emphasise that as well. But you can be very proud, wherever you are, if you're from Limerick, with this incredible display by Limerick. Right throughout the game, right from the beginning, they were masterful. Right throughout the year, they have been unbeaten, and they richly deserve it. And across the last 132 years of the All-Ireland Senior Hurling Championship, just 12 hurlers have captained their county to success on more than one occasion. Mick Mackey is the only Limerick man on that exclusive list. And today, Declan Hannan bids and has joined the magnificent 12 and made it the fabulous 13. The list includes players like Christy Rain, Connor Hayes, Jimmy Doyle, Liam Fennelly, Tom Semple and Anthony Daly. So Mick Mackey, just for the stats, captained Limerick to All-Ireland glory in 1936 and 1940. Declan Hannan does it in 2018. And this year, amazing year of 2020. Full-time score in Croke Park on All-Ireland hurling final day. Limerick winning the All-Ireland on the ninth occasion on a full-time score of Limerick, 30 points. Waterford, 19.
Thank you very much to Marty and to Michael. Well, as a great Gerlach Nan once said, good teams win one All-Ireland, great teams win at least two. And from the man who was probably part of the greatest team we've ever seen play hurling, Henry Shefflin, I don't think anybody ever doubted whether or not this was a great Limerick team. But how important is it that they managed to get this second one, and how likely does it look like they are going to be the dominant team for a little while to come?
Yeah, well, I think for them as players, and for that man, John Kiely, you know, you can see the drive and passion. And Joanne, when we heard the VT at the beginning, John Kiely, the first thing he spoke about was family. Sean Finn appeared on the screen, he spoke about his club. That is the ethos of the GAA. That's what they stand for. Their core values, the standards they set, is the reason why they're here today. And they will be back again. You know, there's 12 of those players between the ages of 22 and 26. They're hitting the peak of their powers. And it was just a phenomenal performance. It was their best performance this year. You know, as Michael said, 24 points from play, 9 different scores, and score from anywhere. And they made it look so easy. But they make it look easy for a reason, because they're putting in the hard work.
Well, there you go. And you're saying that, and seeing the lads out here jumping up and down and in each other's arms, and knowing that their parents and their friends and their siblings and everybody are at home watching in the same way that everybody else is, I don't know what it does to your heart watching it. It gives you mixed emotions.
No, it does, John, but I still think it's magnificent. I think there's joy in every end of Limerick, right from the Clare border down to the Cork border, across to the Tip border. And, you know, their parents will be so, so proud of the way these guys have carried themselves right through the year. And they're a fantastic team. Like, a lot of people spoke about where they dip in the last two games. Like, you have to give credit to the other teams they met as well. And, you know, but they did save the best for last here on All-Ireland final day, 12 days out from Christmas. The Cranberries, again, dreams, and look at this team, are bringing so many dreams for Limerick. You've also to say, you know, a lot of great work done at underage to bring in these players, but John Kiely has been the guy to put the thing, the glue, to put the thing together, and I mean, they're going to be there for a while, there's no doubt about it.
Yeah, it's hard to see, like you mentioned John Kiely, mentioned the Paul Kinnerk as well, coach 3 All-Ireland winning teams now, 1 with Clare and 2 with Limerick. I see Caroline Kerr there. You know, all the pieces of the jigsaw have been put together. Of course, Kylie's the man leading it. He's the boss. He's in charge of all that. But to win an All-Ireland, you need all of these top-class people. But most importantly, you need top-class players. And that Limerick team are exceptional. The players playing the game, like I'm looking at Hagerty there, he's almost like a next-generation hurler. He's playing the game at such ease. They've got power, skill, pace. They can play it long, short. They've been a credit to themselves, a credit to Limerick, and actually a credit to the game of hurling over the last couple of years.
And let's not forget, Henry, a lot of people weren't all that keen on the style that Paul Kinnerk brought to this. You know, the football aspect of it and the short passing, and very non-traditional as well.
Yeah, no, I saw him the first year, 2017, at Kenny Benham in Nolan Park, and the style wasn't good. But you know, when you see it today, like, they just do it so well, Joanne. They play through the lines, they use the ball. But for me, it's the support play. It's the unselfish play. It's always the man in the best position. And that has been drilled into them. I was watching them here before the match, doing a little drill. And you should have seen them striking the ball to hand. You know, we're coaching that as an underage now, strike the hand. And they're just so good at it. And there's a reason for that, because they have the best players. And the best players will perform on the biggest occasions, and that's what we've just seen.
And can I just ask you, from someone who comes from such a traditional area, Ballyhale, is that new then, this striking hand, the drills you're practicing with the underage kids? Is this really just in the last few years that has become such a big part of the drills from an early age?
I think so, because we look at these teams. These are role models. Declan Hannan's a role model now, and these Limerick players are. And they put in the work, but it's their skill levels then. And it's working it through the lines and having the variety in the play. And that's the thing concerning me for Waterford today, is that if Limerick want to go short, they'll go short. If they want to go long into Galan, they can go long into Galan. They have that mixture and that balance of play. And as I said, that's why they are the best team around the last 3 years.
Anthony, you've watched, obviously, their evolution and the structures that they've been putting in place at underage. Back in 2013, they won Munster Senior for the first time in 17 years. I mean, they had been starved for success. Obviously, they got to that All-Ireland final when Henry's team beat them as well. But here you go, Declan Hannan looking to become, as Marty said, the second Limerick captain ever to raise Liam McCarthy for a second time. So let's head back to Marty.
What you're doing in your Armorica expression, the centre, little woods of a sport gosh. As on a rake, the hugging she don't come out to shut. Covoron, Port Lauriga, beg Lord Elgwiv. Can I appeal to all supporters to celebrate this victory in a sensible manner and not tarnish the work of these great players? Agasanish, Kurinche Ahasmur Urum, Kogardagas Gawal de Limni. August Curran Lee McCarthy Gabruna our captain Limney, Declan O'Hanlon.
A very special moment for the people of Limerick and Declan Hannan. Limerick, All-Ireland champions for the ninth time in their history. Declan Hannan joining Mick Mackey, guiding Limerick to two All-Ireland successes as captain. Remarkable. History before your eyes.
Outron coming Luke Lascale. Ta na hisurum, and currently in Vic Corrig, a Glock Arish, air son for in Limney. Firstly, I want to start by thanking the 36 fantastic Limerick players who soldiered so long this year. I don't tell you half enough, lads, but I'm so proud of each and every one of you. The way you conduct yourselves on and off the field, you're an absolute credit to yourselves, to your family, your clubs, your schools, and of course to the county. Thank you very much for the huge effort you put in this year. We've got a fantastic backroom team. There's the bones of 20 plus people involved in it, and each one of them plays a part. Paul Kinnark, Mikey Kiley, our selectors Dodge, Angus, Allen, hurling coach, hurling goalkeeping coach Timmy Houlihan, Kitman, Ger O'Connell, Aver O'Dea, Conor McCarthy, Alan Feely, our nutritionist, Don Murray. Lads, you're super. You do a lot of work behind the scenes. But we see it all and we appreciate everything that you do. To our medical team, particularly this year, they've done a fantastic job of keeping us safe, both at training and match day. Dr. James Ryan, Mark Melbourne, Mark Van Drump, Adrian Kearns. Lads, thank you very much. Our stats team, led by Shawnee O'Donnell, Dini, Kieran, Rory. Again, these boys couldn't be with us today. They're at home in Limerick watching in and feeding all the information through to Shawnee. So lads, we are 100% thinking of you today. To our sports team performance coach, Caroline Currid. Caroline, to you and your family, it's been a tough couple of weeks for you. You're a fantastic person. We are so happy to have you in Limerick, and our thoughts and prayers are absolutely with you and your family at this time. I suppose there's one man there that has to put all the pieces of the jigsaw together. He's our leader. He continues to inspire us. Our manager, John Kiley. To our sponsors, JP and Nori McManus and the McManus family. I hope you're all looking in today, lads. We appreciate absolutely every single thing that you do for us, so thank you very much. To our county board officials, John Cregan, Michael Reardon and Aileen Burke, lads, thank you again. Anything we ask for is given, and we really, really appreciate it. To all the players' families at home, to their partners, lads, we wish you were here. You're with us in the darkest of times and in the happiest of times. We're absolutely thinking of you as well. We can't wait to go home and see you all with the Lee McCarthy Cup. Our schools, our clubs, our colleges, everything you've done for us and growing up, it's ye who played a huge part in us being here today, so thank you a million. Today's match day officials, Fergal and all his guys, thank you very much, you did a fantastic job. To Waterford, I know it's a lonely place to be at the minute, but lads, we have huge, huge respect for each and every one of you. Your management team have done phenomenal this year. You're a fantastic team, fantastic ambassadors for Waterford, and no doubt we'll meet you again next year. I want to pay a special mention to Milford Hospice. We had great fun throughout the first lockdown, hitting the wall for Milford Hospice and raising much needed funds, so lads, thank you for all the work that you do. I want to mention the frontline staff who've worked so tirelessly during this pandemic. The respect that we have for you all in going out there each day to keep us safe is absolutely fantastic. It doesn't go unnoticed by us, so thank you very, very much. Awesome. 2020 has been an incredibly tough year. Businesses have been closed, people have lost their jobs. I know a lot of loved ones have passed away this year who really, really love to be here. To those families, we think of you every single day. You inspire us. We wish you were here, but no doubt they're all looking down from heaven on top of us today, smiling their way down. Lastly, to our supporters, I can picture you here on Hill 16 smiling with giddiness, getting ready to celebrate. We wish you were here. We can't wait to meet you all when it's safe to do so. But I would urge you, as John said, to respect the guidelines. The frontline staff have done phenomenal work in keeping us safe. I hope you enjoy this evening at home with your loved ones. Limerick Abu.
There you go, Declan Hannan, All-Ireland winning captain for the second time, along with his Limerick teammates there. And a lovely touch mentioning the people who, of course, have had such difficulties this year and reaching out to their families who are watching at home as well. And I was wondering, as I was watching Declan Hannan there, in many ways does he sum up this Limerick team, in that he's quiet and self-assured whenever you meet him, and also in terms of his hurling, everybody knows the exact role he's going to play, and yet oppositions don't seem to be able to counter it.
Yeah, he's absolutely solid, Joanne. I would say coming into the game there was a couple of maybe question marks where teams starting to get at him, but especially in the first 40-45 minutes, I think he gave an exhibition of Declan Hannan type role, just holding that centre, making sure that there was no gaps there. But then when there was an opportunity to support, to link up, and he even struck a point there that I recall in the first half. So it was a classic Declan Hannan type display.
But I think it's that unit, just that three half forwards, two midfielders, three half backs. They're so imposing. Like Stephen O'Keefe is looking up the field and he's seen all these gigantic Limerick men. And that's what they are. They just work so well together as a unit, but they're so imposing, just so, so imposing.
I remember hearing John Milan say, actually, that Stephen O'Keefe, he'd look up the field and he's looking for a blue shirt or a white shirt, and he sees not just men, but green men, big green men with sticks.
Yeah. We were talking about some of them, Joanne, and is he big? And I said, he just looks a bit smaller because he's beside Gerard Hagerty or he's beside Dermot Burns. He's a huge man.
Tom Morrissey was the example we were talking about there. Nicky Quaid looked up. There was two Waterford lads there, and he still poked it straight down on top of Tom Morrissey like he was hitting it down on top of Hagerty.
Well, but just explain how difficult that is from the goalkeeper's point of view.
Well, it's ideal from a goalkeeper if you don't have to put yourself under pressure. And if you've got guys like Hagerty and Morrissey and these fellas that you can just drop the ball straight down on top of, sure, we'd need no tactics then, we'd need no short buckles. Our lives would have been a lot easier and less stressful than Joanne. But
sorry, isn't it lovely, the brothers, we saw the Morrisseys there, the Gallans there lifting the cup together, and the Ryans and the Caseys as well, all taking the lifting it together.
Absolutely, but that point you made at half time around the conditioning of the teams, that type of conditioning that all those Limerick players, that doesn't happen over 12 months, doesn't happen over 2 years. I remember a couple of years ago, Paul Kinnark asked me to go down to the academy and just have a chat when he was involved in Clare. He was running the Limerick Academy. And I remember coming away that day thinking, if these young lads are getting all of these messages and this type of environment putting around them, it'll only have to go in one direction for Limerick. And I would say all of these guys, all of that development, all that conditioning, that's when that starts, 6-7 years ago.
Well, it's going to keep on going in that direction. We think Limerick champions for the second time in 3 years, and it looks like they have the ability to keep on going from here. We have more analysis after this.
Littlewoods Ireland, proud sponsor of the GAA Hurling Championship.
And it's in the net, and it's scored by Bernard Brogan. Ben Neville. Bang, bang, bang. Lee Keegan steps up to put Mayo in front.
Free kick to win the All-Ireland.
Dublin take on Mayo in the All-Ireland Football Final. Saturday at 3:40 on RTE2 and RTE Player.
2020 hasn't been normal. But look at us.
Never quite as it seems.
Turn it up, Mary!
This isn't normal. Yeah! This is Hurling to the Core, brought to you by Bord Gáis Energy.
After this year, Tesco believes there's no naughty list, so why not treat yourself with a range of Christmas bites? From our tempura prawns and dumplings to our spring rolls and skewers, they're suitable for freezing and cook at the same temperature, so no need for fuss. Tesco, every little helps.
The National Lottery.
Bye, Gren.
Has caught something of John's essence in this smoky way.
Hey, Gran.
Hey, darling.
I've got something.